geldi. The topic is fan coil configuration in this video. When I open configuration page, I see fan coil function. It has three options, as you see that. Only heating, only cooling, heating and cooling. If you have a system which is using just for heating, you are choosing this one. If it is just for cooling, you must choose this one. In some systems, there is a one unique valve, but it is using for heating or cooling. In that case, you must choose this one. Fan control behavior. As you know that combo actuator is using for output when you wanna control two pipe fan coil unit. And it's using five outputs if you wanna control four pipe fan coil unit. For example, you have a system for two pipe fan coil unit. In that case, the combo actuator needs four relays to control that system. And first channel is for heating or cooling valve. Second one is fan level 1. Third one is fan level 2. Fourth one is fan level 3. I mean it's using three relays for fan level control. And when you choose only one fan output at the same time, it's opening one channel when you send comment for fan level 1. When you send comment for fan level 2, it is closing channel 1 and opening channel 2. If you are sending comment for fan level 3, it is closing channel 2 and opening channel 3. When you choose hierarchically, it is working in different principle. For example, you are sending comment for fan level 1. It is opening just channel 1. When you send comment for fan level 2, it is opening channel 2 but not closing channel 1. I mean for fan level 2, it's using channel 1 and channel 2. And it is using channel 1, channel 2, channel 3 for fan level 3. Heating valve lower limit. When you send percentage value more than 5 or whatever you write here, it's opening valve in that case. If it is not more than this value, it's closing the valve. And you can arrange also fan lower limits in these three lines. For example, from 5 to 30%, it's fan level 1. From 30 to 70%, it's fan level 2. And more than 70%, it's using fan level 3. You can arrange these values. Hysteresis for fan limit. It is the time between fan level changing. I mean, when you put here really small, less value, it will changing fastly from fan level 2 and 3. When you decrease this percentage value, passing from fan level 1 to 2 or fan level 2 to 3 will be faster. Fan time delay for heating, fan time delay for cooling. This parameter set a delay time between opening of heating valve and fan switching on. It means that after heating valve or cooling valve is opened, it's waiting during this time. It's waiting for this time. After that time, it's opening fan. And you can arrange dead time, dead delay time. Heating, cooling, polarization. It's working with zero normally for cooling. And you can invert that value. You can make it one for cooling. Manual fan control. When you make it enable, you can control your fan manually. For example, when you send 2, it's opening fan level 2 directly. But when you make disable for manual fan control, it's opening fan levels depend on your set point temperature. Disabling functions and special functions. Already we have talked similar parameters in previous videos. Because of that, I don't wanna talk it again. We can check its group objects. Manual fan level value. It's 1 byte object. When you send a percentage value, its opening fan level depend on according to your percentage value. And it's checking this configuration. For example, when you send 25%, it's opening fan level 1. When you send 50%, it's opening fan level 2. It's checking your setting. Heating cooling changeover. When you send 1 bit 0, it's opening cooling. And when you send 1 bit 1 value, it's opening heating. Disabling object. If you wanna turn off fan coil control completely, you can use this object. When you send 1 for this object, it's turn off fan coil control completely. When you use this object, you can control a fan coil basically. This is the end of the video. See you in the next video.